which is coming back with another vlog. As you can see, man, with the gray site. For my grandma,
what we doing today? Go on, tell them what we doing, man.
I got my cousin Knock. Man, tell them what we doing today. Explain why we here.
We here because we can do a balloon release. Hey, we can do this two star reveal or whatever. But you know, everybody kind of see because you know that one.
Man, y'all get the room.
Oh, I get him the 500 so we can do this giveaway.
Man, this a whole different channel. Man,
what up?
We gonna be back with y'all.
Make like, comment, share, subscribe.
I'm Shirley Morris. I'm Gloria's sister, her only sister. I miss her so much. I know God knew what was best. And I didn't think, I still can't believe that she is gone. I can't believe it. But I know she is gone, and we have to accept that fact. And we all miss her. We love her. And it's hard for me to get along without her. But when I got home the other day, Helen called. And I'm sorry, she sounded just like Gloria. I thought Gloria was calling me from the grave. And I said, who is this? She said, this is Helen. I said, you sound like Gloria. And I kept saying to Helen, I said, I'm so sorry. I said, no, you don't have to be sorry. You Gloria's sister. And I said, naturally, you would sound like her. But Gloria and I, we talked on the phone every day that she wasn't in the hospital. But we talked every day, sometimes two or three times a day. And we would talk about, you know, personal things that's not personal. We talked about everything. And I miss her from talking to her. And right after she died, I actually picked the phone up to call her. And I said, I'm so old, I can't call her, she's gone. But I miss her so much.
I'm Gloria, next to Gloria, I'm Helen. And I just want to say that I miss Gloria so bad. I call Gloria every, we would talk every, but I'm sure I would call Gloria every morning and every night. And after Gloria's day, what you doing? I'm at peace, but I'm not. I'm not at peace, but I'm fell afraid. But grieving takes time.
Yes, yes.
Yeah. I'm just gonna let it, you know, just let Lord have his way. I was sitting at home in the evening, well, Friday morning, because I took off work. And I found myself just praying and begging the Lord to give me peace with this. I knew this day was coming, and I was trying to prepare myself for it. But it's not a day go by that I'm at total peace. I'm happy that she's in a better place, and I know the Lord has something better for her, and I'm not selfish that I wanted to keep her here. But like I said, grieving is a process, and I just have to go through it, and I don't know nothing else to tell anybody else but just pray like I'm praying, and one day it'll get better. I don't know when, but one day it'll get better. Right. And the Lord don't hold us responsible. You know, he said, weeping and endure for a night, but joy come in the morning.
Yes.
It was morning for Glory, but it's still night for me because I'm still weeping. And I just miss her so much because every day, I mean every day, we talk. And she always was concerned about me getting my rest. And I always was concerned about her getting hers. I tell her, whenever I cook, I said, I'm going to bring you something. She said, don't waste your food. I can't eat it. She said, I can't taste it. I can't do anything. She said, I'm tired, Betty. She said, BJ, I don't know nothing else to do but wait on the Lord. Uh-huh. And that's all you can do is wait on
get off, Grandma, for you going now.
And that last day before she stopped talking, she said, take care of my children. Mm-hmm. And I'm trying, y'all. I'm trying to be there for y'all, but right now I just got to deal with Betty.
Yeah, yeah.
And in the end, you know, we're gonna be there for each other. But right now, we all just have to do what we got to do to get through this thing.
Right.
And that's all I got.
And things ain't gonna be hard, y'all. We done been through this a lot. We did a lot of whole bunch of calls from one another. So we understand. Hey, don't stop trying to get. You know, God gonna take care of all of us. He got his arm around all of us. Yeah, so I ain't gonna tell y'all not to cry. Y'all cry. Because sometimes I feel myself crying. But I got off of work. To get out of here, but it's okay. Don't cry. Don't stop crying. Because I catch myself crying and just right every other day. Mm-hmm. I lost two nephews in one time.
Mm-hmm.
So, y'all hold on. We love y'all. Mm-hmm.
Y'all know I'm the same. But, she wasn't just Gloria, she was Grandma Gloria to me. Cause y'all know Sharon give me a hard time every other day, her and Erica. But Gloria wouldn't let her say nothing about me. She'd be like, what pretty crystal is? And Sharon be like, who? And she was like, you know who I'm talking about. And it's weird not, you know, just feeling her presence. And the anniversary gonna be real different this year. So it's like, I didn't lose just, you know, somebody. I lost a grandmother as well. Cause y'all like family, I've been around y'all for so long. And Betty, and Helen, and Sharon, and everybody, and Monica. And the first time I ever seen Sharon not be strong was when she lost her mom. So that was kind of hard for me. And I ain't gonna cry, hold on. that's my mama, and I'm gonna be there. Just like she was just there for me but 3 weeks ago when I lost my mom. So, mama, you can't be strong all the time. You're gonna have your weak moments.
Yes.
It's okay to be weak.
Yes.
It's okay to break down. And it's okay not to be okay.
Yes.
Us as people think isn't we can't cry. Nah, you gotta let it out. Cause if you don't, you're not gonna be alright. So I just thank everybody just, you know, for holding me in as family, and y'all gonna get through this. We're gonna get through this all together. This is a praying family. That's what one thing I know, y'all gonna pray, y'all gonna sing, y'all gonna shout. Share and shout enough for all of us. I got to catch at every service. But I'm praying for y'all, and I'm for sure a phone call away. We just need to pray together.
This one right here haven't been easy. I'm not gonna even lie. I can't be said, I think about her every day. Because everybody knows she was the life of the party. I mean, she could just be generally talking and have us rolling, crying in stitches from which something she done said crazy, especially after she done cut Sharon out. Poor Sharon, she's a dedicated daughter, baby, because we all know that she would cut you out in a hot second. But, Go this way and let me get caught up in the rapture. A lot of times people say that wrongly. Everybody not gonna go this way, but she had to pass through this way. And one thing I encourage you all to do, because on April the 3rd, it'll be eight years that I lost my husband. And the grief process, ain't that it, it's gonna come and go, it's gonna come in waves. One day you're gonna be good. The next minute you might be bad. The next minute you might be up. But I'm gonna admonish y'all like my pastor admonished me when he called me and I lost my husband. He said, grief is healthy. Y'all need to cry, scream, get in your car, ride. Whatever y'all need to do, do it. But whatever you do, do not lose hope. Your hope is important. Because your hope is tied to your faith. And your faith is tied to your trust in God. And even though she gone, we all would wish she was still here in our presence.
I'm Duncan and Felicia, all of these daughters, for those who don't know. That's my sister and my new friend. I didn't know it was going to be this hard. But
I was so worried about my daddy, y'all. Hey, Sharon, more than anybody. Because when you looking at Sharon, all you see is grandma. And I thought I was gonna come out here and just be like, okay, let's release the balloons and let's go. But my grandma misses so much that I have going on in her. I used to can call her and tell her I'm gonna graduate from college. I'm gonna get married. And she used to be the happiest out of everybody. And she would tell me, don't worry about what my mom and daddy said. Don't worry about what nobody said. Don't worry about it. It's like, you feel empty. I don't think that nobody really understands more than ain't Sharon and my daddy. And my daddy, y'all, he not as strong as y'all think he pretty sure he has his moments, but he tried to be strong for us. And I'm pretty sure he does break down and stuff like that, but he just hurt to know. Like, look at Aunt Sharon. We never seen her like that. And when I look at Aunt Sharon, I just say, that's grandma. She looked just like her. She looked just like her. And it don't even seem real. And I never did think that we would be doing this. I know they all got to go. We all got to go. But I never thought of her just leaving just that quick.
Something to say, I'm Darla.
She will truly be missed. We cried together this morning, and Sharon, if you have your mother still here, please, you don't have but one of those. Let me take the glasses off. You don't have but one mama. Once she's gone, it's all over, said and done. That would have comforted me. And when you can't even just pick up the phone to even just say the word mama, or I love you, I missed you. But one thing I do know about you. But these two had a bond of unrealness, a sister, mother, a friend, no matter what Gloria said to Sharon, Sharon coming through, whether she had to cry or walk or whatever. But truly, I say again, if you have a living mother, sick, whatever, it does not cherish the moment. When you feel you can't do, pray about it. When you feel like you can't go, pray about it. When you feel any kind of way, you got to pray about everything anyway. But God is in control. God is good. It didn't take me and Sharon to be friends for me to pick up the phone to call. I'm who I am. How you doing? I might even ask about Sharon because I had not heard from Sharon. But the love that I had for her, the way she treated me. I've been in this family a long, 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 long time. And I love everybody. And I believe everybody loved me. But I truly say that God is good. He is in control. No matter what it seemed like, no matter what it looked like, he said he'll never leave us or forsake us. And his word stands. So I'm going to say that much where she is truly missed. I love her. My sister, she know I'm right here by her, and she have plenty of support. It ain't just only me because of who she is. So I just thank God for her. I thank God for the family. I thank them for accepting me, the grandchildren, everybody, everybody. So I just want to say still, if you have your parents here, love them all you can while they're here.
Gloria J. Smith Mills.
Yeah.
Gloria was my sister, was my cousin before she was my sister-in-law.
No.
I've been on Gloria a long time. I'm gonna pray, and then if Sharon's coming in, we'll release these rules, y'all. Oh, Heavenly Father, we come, oh, Heavenly Father, to give you glory and give you honor, oh, Heavenly Father. Thank you for the life and legacy of Gloria Nelson, oh, Heavenly Father. We just thank you right now. Bless her, bless her children, oh, Heavenly Father. For you said in your word, oh, Heavenly Father, that we should all come together and be as one body, oh, Heavenly Father. We thank you right now, Lord, for the life and the legacy. We thank you, Lord, for those that are here. We pray now, Lord, that you would use us, oh, Heavenly Father, in a mighty way, that we will continue to run this race. Do what you would have us to do. In the mighty name of Jesus, we pray and ask it all. Amen.
Amen.
Thank God.